are the common side effects of treatment and how are they managed?
So each of the different classes of agents has a different profile of side effects. The BTK inhibitors, the first class that I mentioned with ibrutinib and acalabrutinib, are usually very well tolerated. The most common side effects that we tend to see are things that patients can feel or see, but also things that we can see on the labs when we're monitoring patients. So sometimes you can see lower platelet counts or low cell counts with ibrutinib. That's something that you may not notice, but your doctor is going to notice on the blood count when you come to the office. Sometimes ibrutinib can cause a rash or GI upset. This is usually easily with supportive care from your physician. And then some more common effects of the BTK inhibitors include joint pain and headache. And again, many physicians, because we've been using these BTK inhibitors for some time, have a good regimen for treating these side effects. More uncommon side effects of BTK inhibitors, particularly ibrutinib, that we look out for would be abnormal heart rhythms and some tendency for bleeding. But these are relatively uncommon. And with newer BTK inhibitors, we're seeing lower rates of these side effects. So in terms of venetoclax side effects, we have a little bit of a different profile. This agent is much more likely to cause lower cell counts, especially in a white blood cell count known as the neutrophil count. And so your doctor will be monitoring you for that. In terms of patient side effects that you can feel, it can cause a rash. It can cause some GI upset. These are usually relatively easily managed, but we want you as the patient, if you're on venetoclax, to talk to your doctor about these side effects so that they can help you feel better and help you manage those. In terms of the anti-CD20 monoclonal antibodies, which we use a couple in CLL more frequently, they have very similar side effect profiles. So one is rituximab and one is obinutuzumab. Obinutuzumab is usually used in combination with venetoclax in frontline CLL. Like I mentioned before, this is an infusion. And most of the side effects that we think about and most commonly see in these anti-CD20s are side effects that patients have during the infusion. And these are referred to as infusion reaction. And these are relatively common, around 30% in these anti-CD20 monoclonal antibodies. So what does an infusion center reaction, or sorry, what does an infusion reaction look like? This looks sort of like an allergic reaction. So your nurses in the infusion center are going to be monitoring you very carefully once you start the infusion, and they're going to start it at a low dose very slowly. But the side effects that they're monitoring for, they're looking for changes in your heart rate or blood pressure. You may start to feel hot or cold or sweaty. You may have chills. Sometimes patients can have swelling in their throat or their tongue. And what will happen is, because these are fairly common, is we're still able to give the anti-CD20, but what we do is the nurse will stop the infusion. They may give you some medications that calm down that infusion reaction. So medications like antihistamines or steroids that help tamp down that immune response. And then they start the anti-CD20 infusion at a lower rate. The vast majority of patients will be able to receive an anti-CD20 antibody, even if they have an infusion reaction. They may just need a little bit more of those immune tamping down medications like antihistamines and steroids. And then the last thing to consider, which I think we've mentioned, especially in the venetoclax-containing regimens, is the tumor lysis syndrome. And so that is a side effect that, like we mentioned, is kind of the venetoclax working really, really, really well of the tumor breaking down too quickly. And so patients who have tumor lysis, if they're at high risk, hopefully they're already being monitored very closely with frequent lab draws, and they may receive medications that that diminish the risk of adverse events happening because your electrolytes are out of balance. For instance, your potassium is too high or your calcium is too low. Because your doctors are monitoring you closely, they can give you medications that can help balance out those electrolytes and help protect the kidneys. The tumor lysis is typically not a risk after the initial doses of venetoclax. So the first couple weeks is when we typically monitor that. And then once the CLL has been broken down, or as I like to say, once it's been cooled off a little bit, then you no longer have this risk of tumor lysis and it doesn't require further monitoring.
That's great information. Thank you.